Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. When the world is silent, even one voice becomes powerful. Malala Yousafzai. When you find the courage to use your voice, it has the power to positively change and inspire the lives of others. It is one of the special gifts you have to offer the world and is something to be cherished and championed but never hidden. We at ECHOL believe that let us all be a voice and not an echo. I, Nitya Budhia, on behalf of the principal, teachers and students, welcome you all to the first ever VoiceIt session, Redefining Priorities in the Times of COVID-19 at ECHOL Global International Girls School. VoiceIt is a new initiative of ECHOL Global. It is a talk show which will be both online and offline. It is an opportunity for girls to meet the leaders and inspiring people from different walks of life and share the platform for exchange of thought. We are honored to have amidst us this afternoon Prabhu Chawla sir. Having begun as a reporter and spent over 40 years in journalism, during which he has headed the India Today Group and the Indian Express as editor, sir has witnessed and recorded dramatic changes in Indian democracy. From the trauma of the emergency, the pathos of Rajiv Gandhi's rise and fall, the angst of Mandal, the churning of liberalization and the rise of coalition politics. One of India's finest political journalists, sir, is known for his sharp political analysis and investigative reports. In 20 years as a reporter and editor, he has written extensively on events that changed the political course of India and people who engineered them. He is credited with launching the regional edits of the India Today magazine in Hindi, Tamil, Telugu and Malayalam. He has hosted a weekly talk show, Seedhi Baat, on Aaj Tak, India's most popular television channel. He was awarded Padma Bhushan for the president by the president for 2003. He has won several national awards, including the Hero Honda Indian Television Academy Best Anchor Award for Seedhi Baat in 2005, the TV Anchor of the Year Tele Award in 2003, the TSR Kalapitam Lifetime Achievement Award for 1998, the GK Reddy Memorial Award for Investigative Reporting and Current Affairs 1989, and the Firoz Gandhi Memorial Award for Excellence in Journalism 1985-86. He was also the editor of India Today and editorial director of the India Today Group of Publications, editor of Indian Express and Financial Express from 1991 to 1996. We welcome you, sir. We are glad and thankful that you kindly accepted to be here with us this afternoon. I would now like to call upon our principal, Ms. Manija Subramaniam, to kindly speak a few words.
Good afternoon, all. On behalf of our students and our family, ECHOL Global International Girls School, I welcome our guest, Padma Bhushan awardee, Mr. Prabhu Chawla ji. ECHOL, as Nitya has said, has started with a series of talk, VoiceIt. And it's a proud privilege to all of us that Prabhu Chawla ji, who is a Padma Bhushan awardee, is the guest for our first talk. There is a lot that has been read and discussed, especially in the recent times. Now, this kindles the mind of whys and hows that's happening in this world. It is said that, you know, desires dictate our priorities, and our priorities change, give shape to the choices that we make, and the choices determines our action in turn. We all understand that our priorities in the recent times underwent a drastic change. There are times or there are topics, very sensitive topics, such as the underprivileged who is able to barely manage their food. A lot of them can be seen from the different community, which probably is very sensitive to discuss on near the traffic signal place where, you know, on a regular day, I'm talking about a regular day, sir. So they depend on alms that they receive. But then during this particular period, when all those things have closed down, naturally their priorities got redefined. Students who are expecting a substantial educational standard as per their capabilities, name it here in India or abroad, do not want to miss a year or even a month because it raises the palpitation. Something else which is very sensitive if we look at in the present time when we see the news is the priority of the family, where they have lost a lot of them because of the COVID. For them, the priority probably today would be giving them a proper emotional closure to the loss that they have because of the shortage of land and other things. I would like to understand, we all would like to understand. So you on a daily basis experience, and then you talk, you discuss with people from different walks of life, understanding what is it that's happening with them? What is it that decides on the priority? So if you can give us your views, how things have changed, how priorities underwent redefinition, especially in these times. Sir.
Thank you very much for inviting me. I'm really grateful to the Iqbal family for thinking of me. I'm quite old, and talking to young students who are below the age of 20 is really a good luck for me, because I always try to learn even as I'm getting old, because it's better to learn and unlearn something which we have learned in the past. So I believe in the process of learning something new from young people, because they have much more access to information sources. They are much more creative. They are much more brilliant. They are much more able to take risk. And therefore, when you talk to these young people, you always feel that you have missed something in the past. As the country moves forward, or globally we move forward from a car-driven society to jet-driven, flown society, you feel so many things are happening under you. But coronavirus, for example, is something which nobody expected. It's the first time in the history, if we know history, that's what we know, that the entire world has been paralyzed. First time in the history, human history, we know that nothing could move beyond some certain distance within your own four walls of the house. That never happened before. Cars were not moving. Buses were not moving. Schools were closed. Gyms were closed. Everything was closed. I was talking the other day to auto manufacturer. They told me one thing, that in the month of April, not even one car was sold in India. Perhaps in the world, only 230 big cars were sold during that month. When you sell millions of automobiles every day, and you come to a situation, there are no buyers in the street. So obviously, something has happened for which we were not ready at all. We could not cope with the new situation, how to handle something which is an invisible enemy who was attacking you from somewhere or nowhere. You never knew whether you're going into the bathroom, you'll get attacked by it, or you're going to meet somebody, you'll get attacked by it, or you're breathing and you'll get attacked. So we were so visibly petrified that we are facing an enemy who cannot be shoot. We cannot shoot because there's nothing available there. So obviously, when you see this kind of situation, which was not expected, you feel that their priorities have to be different. Only one formula which everybody came, which were we are also practicing earlier also, mask, for example. If you go to the operation theaters or you go to areas of China, for example, I visited a couple of times 20 years ago when I visited Beijing, there were people with masks because it was the most polluted city. So mask was something which became some kind of a symbol of modern society now. You hide earlier visibility of a person defined the personality of that person. Now the quality of mask defines your personality. That's the difference between now and then. If you have a better mask, I have seen a chief minister who was changing his mask according to the shirt he was wearing. You have seen the Prime Minister also, he changes his safa which he wears around on every occasion. So this is, mask has become a statement of fashion as well as the protective gear to protect yourself from anything which is attacking you. The priorities are changing. You are defining everything that how it is going to help me to save from corona. Corona is a disease which nobody knows how to cope with it. So when you're saying priorities, There is a problem there, because when during the 4 months, I'm talking in terms of relatively, that I think silence in this world became much more powerful than the noise which are happening. Earlier, noisy skies, noisy roads, noisy hospitals, noisy schools, noisy colleges, they were creating some kind of a life, of course, but they were also generating some kind of a pollution, what we call it. And the silence in the sky, silence on the road, made this country much better livable. Now you find, I can see the sky is blue. You can see the river flowing near next to you, which are the most polluted river. If you go there, you can see the bottom of the river now, which you could not see earlier. So these are the side effects of what has happened, unfortunate thing to the world. And accordingly, we are changing the priority, that what we were doing earlier was okay or not. In the fight for development, creating more aircrafts, creating more cars, or manufacturing something, was it a symbol of development or something else? And we were the richest. For example, I'm talking about the growth of India and growth of other societies. If you look in terms of growth of various parameters, everything is gone. Ultimately, you had the, what you call, the ocean of wealth with you, but you could not face a single enemy, which is inimitable. So all the wealth, all the science, all the technology, all the nuclear science could not do anything. People are dying on the street. So obviously there was something missing, that okay, something which comes, which you don't expect. How would we treat with that kind of situation? We were not prepared for that. So this is a priority now, that this has given you an opportunity to look in the future, that what could be possible. We stop planning for the future in terms of healthcare, in terms of education. We are planning for today. That is what the problem was happening, that we did not learn any lessons from the past. Even our past was good or bad. Something which happened today is made on the basis of yesterday, and tomorrow is made on the basis of today, but we are not thinking of day after tomorrow. Thing has come now, okay, this pandemic has happened now. What would happen 5 years from now or 10 years from now? Something else may hit you. You're looking at the phenomena of now, earthquake coming more often. Tsunamis type things are coming more often. You look at number of things that are happening all over the world. Even in Delhi, during the past 45 days, we have got 7 tremors, which have never happened. So are we ready for that? So we are not looking, because everybody is rushing in terms of, I agree with the Prime Minister when he says we must help the wealth creators. But the question is, if in the process of creating wealth, are you losing the life of the planet as a whole? Because we are not looking at what is sitting below the earth, what is happening over the earth. So therefore, even pandemic, therefore, I would say, had given us priorities, that how to think ahead of the time and get ready for that. For example, your school is one of the best school in that area. You must be thinking after students go and they score maximum marks, say 99% is the limit these days. 99% also people got. When we were studying in the school and colleges, we couldn't think of even 75%. At that time, 75% was distinction. Now we don't know who is a distinguished student and is an ordinary student, because everybody gets more than 90%. So this competitive world has made valuation is also irrelevant. So we have to think in the priorities what is happening. There are different kinds of IQs you have got. There are 8 kinds of IQs, there are 20 kinds of IQs, depends how you look at the situation. So when you're talking of reprioritizing yourself, I would think that now the time has come where everybody, from school to universities to municipal corporation to Prime Minister of India, they have to think in terms of what it stands for us in the future. How you look at the future, because we are not looking at the future at all, we are looking at the present. So we have to prioritize ourselves, how to make our today better, how to make our day after much better than today, and what will be the best future scenario for us in terms of all fields, not only education, but everything. How to make the society a better, healthier, and wealthier in terms of not only money, but in terms of mind, vision, and everything else. So we have to think in terms of that. Future has to be better than today, that is no doubt about it. But were 20 years ago, today in 2020, did anybody in 2000 think that 2020 will face this kind of situation, the world will stop and 30% decline in the wealth of the nation happen? We never were ready for that. So therefore, whatever you do from the micro level to the macro level, you must think of the future. When I'm constructing a classroom, is it equipped to handle what kind of changes will be required 20 years from now or 10 years from now? School life is outward, that building life is 30 to 40 or 50 years. Is the ground enough for to handle various kind of different kind of games which will come up? Now I see most of schools don't have even school games even happening. When we were in the school, we used to go for a school games also. There are grounds which are there. Now I don't find games is not a priority even. Sports is not a priority even in this country. There were NCC, there were scouts, and there were something else. But now everything is there. Okay, what kind of gadget I can give to my student? My iPhone, I got it. Whether I got a Bluetooth, I can use it. Whether I can go to Google, whether I can do this or that, TikTok and something, that is a priority of this country now, which has to go beyond that. That are these giving me something which can sustain my life for next 50 years? Every life of an Indian now is 80 years. In 80 years, we are the oldest country in terms of we are the youngest, we are the oldest country as well. About 70% of the population is below 35, 40 years of age. But when they become older, what will happen to India? Because 40 years, those who have got 80 crore people who are now 40 years old, and 40 years from now, you will have 200, 150 crore people of 80 years old in this country. What will happen? I shudder to think of that. So therefore, priority has to, for young generation has to be, okay, I'm in the school now. What could I do? Learn it so that I can survive my own lifestyle. 30 years, 40 years from now, how am I to upgrade myself from 25 to 30, 30 to 35, 40, 40, and whatever the space, you have to work accordingly and do some. That's the only thing you can do it. So I would leave it to ask question that priorities have to change from looking better, healthier. Yes, that should be there. The fashion there, I wouldn't say even the young people going to gym and showing you six packs or four packs, which the film star do most of the time. That may be good to look at, but do they survive you as an actor or whatever? So you have to have something which is sustainable. Good Indian culture is the only sustainable culture. Others are coming and going, that's all. I would leave it to you. You can ask any question you want.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the insight. May I request Nitya to take over and see what our friends have to ask?
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. So after your wise words, our students are very inquisitive to talk to you and we have been flooded with questions. So we'll take the questions one by one. The first question is from Mehak Agarwal of grade 12.
Good afternoon, sir, and everyone present here. This is Mehak.
Raise your hand, I can see at least. Raise your hand, then I can see who's where.
Sir.
Yes, good. Yeah, please, Mehak, bete.
Yeah. So today, I'm not just a global citizen, but also a part of the youth of this generation that covers most of the population. So from a day in classroom to sitting for those monotonous online sessions the next day, from board examinations to no examinations, how do you think is the online sessions or the, you know, education system getting impacted by this period of time?
You see, you already defined monotonous session on online, which is already, you think it is giving you any, you are defined already. You are giving you an answer that this is not what you are liking. If I'm wrong, please correct me. So when you say it's the monotonous, because it's something new, which I have not handled in my life. Because they're going to 40 people at the same time sitting in Dehradun, and I'm here. We have been doing webinar shows, one person sitting in Toronto, one in Calcutta, one in Delhi, one in Chennai. So this was never happening earlier. Face-to-face discussion, of course, is interaction much more better. Right. Education system, you have to look at the education system. It's something, education is a science. It's a science of learning something. Because education is not a static subject. It is a very big subject. Education can be related to what books you read, what kind of curriculum you have been given. Education also thing, but you do outside the school boundary walls also. Because you spend 5 hours to 6 hours in the school, remaining 18 hours you are spending outside the school. Those 18 hours, what do you learn? That is also education. So when you are getting bored, monotonous online education, you can also indulge in something very active which you like, gives you much more information, which you don't get otherwise. You can interact with your friends. You can talk, read the books, which you must be doing anyway. And for example, my own grandchildren, they're 9-year-old, both are there, they're 12, I can watch, they're what they are not got out the gate of my house for the last 3.5 months. But they never felt bored. I'm surprised. They don't want to go out. Within their own boundary walls of the house, which they've got enough space to play around there. But they have, I discovered them, they have created their own niche. Can you believe in 45 days, my granddaughter, she's a student of third class only, has read 106 books. I have not read in throughout my life. I was not a good learner anyway. I never read books. They do creativity. They do something else, which is not part of the school. And there is an online school classes happening every day. They are learning. My grandson has picked up Spanish classes. He's playing there. There are many other children I know who have done something which they were not expected to do anything. Because this is the time which you are saying, what do you do in the corona time? You can acquire skills which you never had earlier. Because you are not going to school. Your teacher is not putting you pressure to have homework and come back with that. You don't have a pressure of tests also, which is happening regularly. So you can learn something which, as you said, you are a global citizen. That is something which is the modern girls and boys and young generation likes, to be a global citizen rather than the Indian citizen. Priority is global citizen, which I am very frank, as a grandfather, like I can tell you. This global citizen phenomena, nobody is a global citizen now. Trump is Trump. He talks of America. He doesn't talk about anything else. Modi talks about India. It is India. So we have to forget for the time being a global citizen is not is the one who looks after the interest of everybody else. But are you willing to sacrifice something for China? No. Are you willing to sacrifice something for Pakistan? No. So where are you global citizen? Inside you are Indian. So what I'm trying to say, you must pick up your Indian, I would say India has a rich heritage. I'm saying in terms of jo aajkal whatever they're teaching, kada pi lijiye, tulsi pi lijiye, ye sab pi lijiye, hamare ghar mein pehle se pilate the. Ab sari duniya pi rahi hai usko. We are exporting ginger, everything else from India. It has gone up by 30% in 3 months. Even Trump wants to drink that. So what I'm saying, our Indian culture, which is much more cheaper and much more earthy, easily available. I'm just saying that these are the things. I'm not saying that you should follow that. You should also follow the modern science and everything else. But what is good for us, we don't want to own it. Question that, our Indian heritage. For example, I don't know how many of you have read Gita. Gita is not a communal or Hindu book. How many people have read Bible? They are gems of wisdom there. One should read them. If you read Gita, you will find that there are many practical solutions how to handle manpower, how to manage the relationship, how to win a war in terms of not only physical war, also win the wars of arguments. Because ultimately life is competitive. You have to grow, you have to do much faster than your colleague, your sister, your brother. In South, there is a company, my brother has got 80%, I would like to have 70%. He is earning 1 lakh rupees a month, I earn 5 lakh rupees a month. These kind of good things are happening. But when you say how this thing is happening, it depends how you use technology for your own betterment. Your horizon of mind should become like an ocean, which has unlimited capacity. But if you make like a well, then nothing can go, it will remain there. So you expand your mind from a well to an ocean. You will find that whatever you grab, still you need more. Don't go for the appetite, don't eat more. That is limited. So you must grab more. So therefore, keep mind as capacity of learning many things, which I've learned at the moment now. I'm able to have a Zoom discussion at the age of 75. I'm learning it. I can't compete with you girls and boys. And you're brilliant, all of them. So what you are saying, global citizen, what not, first become the Indian citizen. What is good for India should be like boon boon se gada banta hai ya batta hai. Agar India bhi achha ho jayega, to sara global citizen bhi achhe ho jayenge, bhai. Abhi to apne aap ko sudhariye, make yourself big. India is the biggest good country. India has many things to teach the rest of the world. And we should be proud of our own country.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
We have the next question from Parinita Singh of Grade 10.
Good afternoon, sir.
Raise the hand, please.
Good afternoon, sir.
Raise the hand. Very good.
Hello? I'm Parinita from Grade 10. So, sir, as we all know that the Indian government's decision to ensure a complete lockdown has obviously resulted in the loss of Indian economy. However, I feel that India's condition is not too recessive either. So how do you think that it is a great opportunity for India to emerge as an economic leader post-COVID-19?
You're absolutely right, because we are not the only country to have a lockdown. Many other countries have done it. Many countries still not lifted the lockdown. Our states are, you see, what is happening? I have a big fight on this issue of figures. First, let me go back to first figure, then I'll talk to you and give your answer. Everybody you read in the newspaper in the morning or see the TV, number of cases cross 500,000. Are bhai, when the cases who have recovered, are they part of 500,000? When something has gone, it's gone. It's not part of India, the figures. When you say that there are 5 million, 500,000 people, out of which 287,000 people have recovered, why are you counting them as Indian cases? They're gone. There's some kind of a conspiracy global-wise by pharma companies to create a panic by raising the number, keeping the number increasing. They must give the figures, okay, today's active cases are so many. In a country of 130 crore people, we have got only 214,000 acting cases. We have recovered more, 67% people have recovered. Why you are counting them in the number of cases? I don't understand the logic. Because you want to set up more beds, there can be corruption. There can be setting up beds then after bed when the Delhi, for example, we have got only 32,000 active cases. But you're putting up a bed of 10,000 in one place. I don't understand. 20,000 more being created, 30,000. So when you give this kind of picture, it leads to young mind that, okay, country is going to be captured by coronavirus everywhere. 85% of our Indian cases are confined to only 10, 12 cities. But yes, we should be precaution. We should be taking precaution because the immunity level of our Indians are much higher than the other countries because our lifestyle is better. We eat certain things which are good for immunity. Therefore, what you are saying that it can be opportunity for our economic development. Yes. Unfortunately, panic was created. Labor was allowed to move on the road. 1 crore people have gone back to their villages. Earlier, they came to urban cities to create palaces, airports, roads, and they were living in the slums. In villagers created rich India. They were deprived of the health facilities. And without them, you could not have created airports, you could not have created big highways, you could not have created big hospitals, you may not have created big factories. And once they were in trouble, you stopped giving them money. They were on the road. I know next to my house, there were laborers from one big company, I don't know to name it. 2,000 people working for a big project. After Corona, the company stopped giving them food, giving them salaries, contract ran away. And we collected some of the NGOs from our area, who collected money and fed them for a couple of weeks. So these are the people who are the real wealth creators, who are taking a brick on his shoulder or her shoulder, having a fawada apne aath mein khud ki khet jaati hai. Wo log jo hai, unko jab tak aap dekhenge nahi, because you allowed India, rural India to move to urban areas, because rural India is kept poor, no facility, no school, no water, nothing. You should have created rural India first. Aap Bharat ko bhool gaye, India ko banane mein lag gaye. तो 5,000 करोड़ का आपने IIT बना दिया, 5,000 करोड़ के IIM बना दिए, भाई अच्छे स्कूलों के अंदर खर्च करिए, अच्छे हॉस्पिटल बनाइए शहरों के अंदर, वहां पर लोग जाएंगे. Why don't you cluster villages converted into, वहां भी मॉल होने चाहिए. गांव के बच्चे क्या मॉल में नहीं जाना चाहते, पिक्चर देखना नहीं चाहते. बट यू डिनाइड देम फैसिलिटी एंड यूज देम एज लेबर टू क्रिएट फैसिलिटीज फॉर द रिच पीपल. नाउ इज द टाइम अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर अस, यूज द विलेजेस इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर टू डीकंजेस्ट द सिटीज. Take them, let everybody go to the villages, छोटे छोटे town में जा करके वहां पर अच्छे स्कूल बनाए, कॉलेज बनाए, मॉल बनाए. अब तो IT है, you can do anything sitting anywhere. So therefore, opportunity, like अभी PPE बना रहे हैं लोग, वेंटिलेटर बना रहे हैं, मास्क बना रहे हैं. It has happened, but it is very partial, not even less than 0.1% of our GDP. GDP will come when you start giving money in the hands of the people. पैसा नहीं है. SMEs के पास पैसा नहीं है. आपने पैकेजेस सारे अनाउंस कर दिए, दे आर गुड पैकेजेस, बट इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ठीक होना चाहिए उनका. ऐसे अब स्कूल बंद है, स्कूल के अंदर अगर पैसे नहीं आएंगे, टीचरों को तनख्वाह कहाँ से मिलेगी? तनख्वाह नहीं मिलेगी तो बेचारे खरीदेंगे कहाँ से जाके, बाहर जाकर के. डिमांड कंट्रैक्शन होगा, देयर बी प्रेशर ऑन द मैनेजमेंट कि टीचर्स को तनख्वाह दीजिए. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, वी जर्नलिज्म, अवर जर्नलिज्म एडवर्टाइजिंग रेवेन्यू विच वी रन ऑन एडवर्टाइजिंग. अखबार आपको हम 5 रुपए में देते हैं, बट इट कॉस्ट अस 15 रुपीज टू प्रिंट ए पेपर. 10 rupees come from advertising. वो 10 रुपए बंद हो जाएंगे तो बाकी तनख्वाह कहाँ से देंगे? Ultimately, all the newspaper has sacked some people. They have reduced the salaries. They are sustaining it yourself. So this is the time, as you rightly pointed out, we have to think of some innovative way. नया तरीके से सोचना होगा. At minimum cost, you do the maximum work. Cost has to come down. Innovative mission has to be there. Demand in the hands of the people have to be given them. And therefore, you must give more employment to people, middle level people, lower level people. बड़े लोगों को देने से कोई फायदा नहीं है. तो इसलिए यू हैव टू क्रिएट डिमांड फॉर पीपल हु आर लिविंग. एक 80 करोड़ पीपल यू आर सेइंग $2,500 पर कैपिटा इनकम इन द वर्ल्ड वी हैव गॉट एज अगेन $25,000 ऑफ अमेरिका. यू आर कंपेयरिंग योरसेल्फ विद अमेरिका. चाइना हैज गॉट मच 10 टाइम्स मोर देन अस. दे हैव द मनी इन देयर हैंड्स बट वी डोंट हैव द मनी. 2500 में भी अगर आप देखेंगे ड्यूरिंग द लास्ट 5 ईयर Top 1% rich people have got 70% of the income of India. So it means remaining 99% ke paas 30% hai. What will they buy? School ki fees denge, ghar ka kiraya denge, gaadi denge, bachcho ko denge. So this is the time for us to go into rejig our economic model, which was a supply model. Aapne manufacturing and everybody ko income tax concession diye, unke liye capital gains tax maaf kiya. Now you go back to the village. India can survive only if you go back to the villages. Let the urban area, people like Mukesh Ambani have a house somewhere in Bhagalpur in Bihar. Set up there and see what happens. If you can create Rajkot, why can't you create Bhagalpur also? They can do it. I asked one of the, I had a CIA session. I asked all the top CEOs in one of the webinars. I said, how many of you have given huge land which is lying in your factories for setting up a COVID center? Not even one. So this outlook had to change. The people who are working for you, creating your wealth, you must look after them throughout 24/7. So this is an opportunity. You have rightly pointed out. We must rejig our economic priorities. We must follow the demand side model. We must have the labor intensive creation. अमेरिका 1940s में जब आया था उन्होंने दे स्टार्टेड कंस्ट्रक्टिंग रोड थ्रू आउट द अमेरिका. जो इतनी सारी रोड आप देखते हैं वहां पर दे वर स्टार्टेड दैट टाइम 1940s. दे आर बीइंग मेंटेन्ड नाउ. चाइना कैन क्रिएट सो मेनी रोड्स. द रोड इज समथिंग व्हिच नॉट ओनली गिव्स जॉब टू मिलियंस ऑफ पीपल. इट कनेक्ट्स वन सिटी टू अनदर, वन विलेज टू अनदर. व्हेन यू स्टार्ट कनेक्टिंग ऑन द रोड साइड यू विल फाइंड होटल्स, यू विल फाइंड मोटेल्स, यू विल फाइंड हॉस्पिटल. एवरीथिंग विल डेवलप ऑन द रोड साइड. व्हेन अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी स्टार्टेड डेवलपिंग दिस highway, he was the first prime minister to start it. Then he started connectivity. I used to call him a connectivity prime minister. He connected the country in terms of roads. He connected the country in terms of mobile phones. He connected the country by taking all the parties together. He was the best connector. So your economic model can work only you go on the connectivity, economics of connectivity in every field.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
So we have 3 very similar questions. So, so if we could hear them out, 3 of them, and then you can answer. So the first person, Pranjal Vasan of grade 12.
Sorry, say it again.
So Pranjal Vasan, so we have 3 very similar questions with us.
Yeah.
So we could take 3 of them at the same time, and then, sir, if
please
could answer. So, so the first person, Pranjal Vasan of grade 12, are you here with us?
Yes, yes. Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah.
I'm Pranjal. So as we all Pranjal. Know, that many people are going into the state of depression, and it's really disheartening to know that people are taking steps towards suicides. So how do you think that social distancing and isolation has really had an impact on people's mental health?
You have raised a fundamental question. What is happening very unfortunate. What that some of the people have come to suicide because of depression, social distancing. They are used to some kind of outgoing, outing. They go for picnic, they go meet friends. They can't tolerate this isolation. But I'm putting a bigger perspective. I wouldn't call it is because of the coronavirus. Because if you look at, people are saying so many people have died. In Delhi, so many people have died. Looking at the figure, more people have died on diabetes and heart attacks and other disease in Delhi hospital than they have died in corona. Where are the suppressing figures of other deaths? I don't understand. So there is some kind of a deliberate plan on the part of whosoever is handling it to highlight a particular problem by giving inflated figure, including the people who are recovered as part of the active total cases, which is illegal, which is crime, I think. They should not add people who have recovered into the total number of people affected, because they are no more affected. You are adding them into the number. So when you are saying depression is happening, there are a couple of cases happening, but it depends on the local situation, how the parents, how the persons around them, some of them lost businesses, they have committed suicide because they could not cope with the financial hardship, which happens even normal times also. So I would not say we are, something has happened, it is not because the corona times would have happened otherwise also certain situations. So when you say so many things are happening, it may happen later, it lasts longer, because the 4 months is quite a long time. If it happens longer, there may be psychological problems happening there, and psychiatrics has to get into the pictures there. So you have to, it is a responsibility of the friends, guides and parents to keep a watch on their children, that what they are doing at home alone, whom are they mixing, what kind of things are they seeing on the phone. So it depends on how you deal with the isolation, because one person is not alone. If somebody is alone, then there is a problem, because nobody is there. Like some suicide has happened, Sushanta, if you look at that, is it because of corona or is it because of something else? It is still being investigation. But he was alone. If somebody is alone at home and you look at somebody else like Anupam Kher, he's creating video every day, creativity. He's also alone. His mother sometimes comes, brother comes, sometimes comes. He's dancing around. You must have seen he was dancing with his mother, he was dancing with his brother. There are many people who are doing very interesting things at home. I do the different thing at home because I'm there at home at every day. I come to office only once or twice, once a day, week maximum. I do myself, I do the plantation, I cut the trees, I climb the trees, I water the lawns. I do various things. I play with my grandchildren, but I have developed something which I was not doing earlier. I did many things. I pulled out my old records, reading on them. You have to find out how to keep yourself busy. Depression happens when you see that you don't have a confidence in your own self. When you lose the confidence in yourself, then you have a tendency of losing out. You are a loser because you think you can't do this. You can do everything. Try. If you fail, then you commit suicide. Yeah, I don't say you can commit suicide. But if you, without trying, you commit suicide, it means you are accepted defeat before even trying. So these are the isolation cases. You should not bother about it. As a youngster, you must just forget it. It happened. Unfortunate, it should not have happened. But we should avoid isolation of mind. Isolation of mind is the problem. If you become closed mind, isolated, looking at only one thing, ये नहीं हो रहा, ये नहीं हो रहा, ये नहीं हो रहा, तो उसके बाद वही होगा जो उसने किया. तो यू मस्ट ओपन योर माइंड अप, लुक आउट द विंडो, फाइंड समथिंग, इवन चर्पिंग ऑफ द बर्ड, यू विल फाइंड समथिंग इंटरेस्टिंग. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन.
थैंक यू सर.
सर, द अदर टू क्वेश्चंस आर आल्सो वेरी सिमिलर, सो लेट्स लिसन टू देम. एंड सर, इफ यू वुड वांट टू ऐड ऑन टू समथिंग यू सेड. So, sir, we have Arushi Khurana from Grade 12.
Good afternoon, sir.
Just a minute. Oh, my table is okay. Sorry, huh?
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah,
sir, I'm Arushi Khurana.
Yeah.
Sir, we have seen in the recent times that the topic of mental illnesses has come to the forefront. Every day, the news bulletins have suicide reporting. So I would like to ask you that what would be your suggestion to everyone on ways of staying positive during the current situation?
That's the question I was answering earlier also. Number of suicide cases of various variety has gone up in the country. But fortunately for us, in a country of 130 billion people, 130 crore people, percentage is very low as compared to the Western world. So I would not, because the media is there and you get more information which was not available there. Yes, mental problem is happening, economic depression is happening, most of the people are happening. Different reasons are different for suicide. But most of the difference are the economic reasons, which I have studied in the research bureau. The economic reason people are happening, and then people plus 30 are committing more suicide. Younger generation, sometimes you find when the exam results come, you find a couple of cases where the people, a person was expecting, I would have got 90%, but I got 97%. They go and commit suicide. These are the possibility which is happening every time. So possibility, you can only thing is, as I told you earlier, you have to keep a good company. As they say, every you must have seen, a person is known by the company he or she keeps. And I would say, person known by the books or everything she or he reads, or what kind of going games you play. So your other social activities, once you are out of the school for 18 hours a day, 8 hours you are sleeping, remaining 10 hours, what you do? That will keep you away from negative thought. Positivity is that you must look at the thing which you have not done. You do start doing that. Okay, I want to learn a foreign language. Because when you are, somebody is saying, I'm a global citizen, he should be doing first thing to learn the global language. One. So one, whatever aspiration you have got, your aspiration become the source of positivity. Because you are aspirational citizen, aspirational young girl, you have certain aspiration in terms of academics, in terms of whatever businesses you want to do, in terms of wealth. You find out the ways of looking at how to keep this, convert these aspirations into an opportunity. And for that converting in opportunity, what steps you have to take, you start climbing the ladder one by one. That is positive.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. So we have a next question from Rizita Chaudhary of Grade 12.
Sorry, I am taking my water. Yeah, please.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Rita Chaudhary from grade 12. Sir, PM Narendra Modi, in his national address Tuesday, said the COVID-19 crisis has taught India the importance of local manufacturing and supply chain. It is time to be vocal about local, he said. And as he spoke about the importance of Atmanirbharta, that is self-reliance. So my question for you, sir, do you think vocal for local is a good step to revive Indian economy?
As I said in the beginning, there are too much in India which is much more precious than we thought about it. I don't agree with what Ramdev does. But most of the things which have you got, they see things, they are very good for our things and we are exporting most of them. Vocal for local is a thing because we were not able to import anything because everything was closed. We are dependent for medicines and every pharmaceutical company totally depended, about 45% of pharmaceutical industry depended on China. When the supply chain is broken, when you want to start something, do you realize we are depending too much on everything abroad? We are getting part of our defense system was weakened because we could not get certain things from various countries. So he spoke about vocal for local because he saw within the primacy, he's got much more information than we have got. He realized that India depends in manufacturing sector, in services sector, on foreign sources for surviving itself. Because all the planes, we don't produce commercial planes here. They come from abroad. Their parts come from abroad. Even technology, for example, Google stops today. We will not be able to talk here. We are doing it. So if they want to disconnect India from the rest of the world, they can do it in one button. So we have started now. Somebody started doing what I'm looking at something that TikTok ki jagah ko Indian. Somebody is sitting in Chennai has produced that. Is that the priority of India? TikTok, theek hai, hua tha, rok liya aapne, but TikTok is not going to connect India. What is connecting? Communication with you and my Indian fellow person. Because Modi is much more active on social media. His Twitter account, 54 million people. If somebody sitting today in India decide, okay, he's cut Facebook, what will he do? Modi is used to social media. Nobody will see his face. Moment you open anything, you find Modi there. Modi knows how to use the media. So when he started talking local for local, he realized that even he can be put into problem by these international companies who are supplying us some kind of a software. Earlier also he spoke in 2015, made in India. He must be remembered, made in India for the rest of the world. But he forgot after that because bureaucracy did not take it forward. Made in India, you have to made in India. But what is happening now? Most of the things we are importing from abroad. Only food we are producing self-sufficient there. But we have to be local for India. Like masks are being made of cotton here. We are the largest supplier of masks to the rest of the world now. They are made in India. In Bihar, mein se I got it made from Bihar, Madhubani. They got the work. And mask has something which is cheap. You can throw it every day. I change it every second day. I don't keep the thing. So I'm saying even ventilator, even something else made in India is being made because abroad they did not have enough capacity to supply to India. So therefore, Vocal for India is a very good idea, the Prime Minister has given. But you are dependent too much on, if you look at the Vivo you have got there, Oppo you have got Chinese, and they are saying boycott the Chinese product. 85% of your pharmaceutical country depends on the from China. So he is preparing for the future. So therefore, Vocal for Local is a futuristic slogan. It cannot be implemented now. But we have to get ready at your age and younger age. They must, for example, toys. We are ordering toys for my grandchildren from somebody which is companies abroad. Why Indian toys industry, which used to make earlier, had gone down the drain? These are the basic things, we educational books, for example. Harry Potter sells more millions of copies in India. Not any other Indian author can make it. Money is going out of it. We are sending about 90 lakh crore rupees every year, 90,000 crore rupees every year for teaching, sending our children abroad for study. Why can't they study here? So therefore, what he meant is that our Indian system should be strengthened in such a way that the Indian should be being studying in India. All the people, big industries, gave money to Harvard, they gave money to MIT and sent their children there. Millions of dollars have been given to them. Even Prime Minister Manmohan Singh gave money to the foreign universities, Oxford University, not to Delhi University, where he studied and taught. So we have to be proud of India first. One thing which is talking about it, his slogan always reflects some kind of a Indianness. Bharatiyata ki uske andar khushbu aati. Vocal for Local means you should become self-reliant in terms of thinking, in terms of pehnawa, in terms of everybody looks alike now. मैं भी जीन पहन लेता हूँ, जाते हर सड़क पे जाओगे, मेरा ड्राइवर भी जीन पहनता है, मैं भी जीन पहन लेता हूँ, आप भी जीन पहनते हैं, मेरी डॉटर इन लॉ भी पहनती है, मेरा बेटा भी पहनता है, ग्रैंड चिल्ड्रन भी पहनते हैं. तो जीन हैज बिकम समथिंग विच इज नॉट ए लोकल थिंग. वी हैव फॉरगॉटन कुर्ता पजामा. देयर द मोस्ट ईजी थिंग, हेल्दी थिंग, एयरी थिंग, बट फैशनेबल टू गो अब्रॉड. अब फॉरेन कंपनी की जीन चाहिए, गंदी हो जाती है, बदबू आने लग जाती है. When he said local for Mughal, doesn't mean that something. He said, okay, think of India. Whatever good in India, use that. Whatever we can't make in India, yes, we can import that. Made India, make for the world. His slogan is very good. If you start thinking local, I'm telling you, that is the only way of becoming the superpower in the world, because we have the demand. Everybody is coming to India because they think the demand. All of these companies, Google, Facebook, they're making millions of dollars out of India. They make less money from Americans than from India. Why have not been able to develop it? I ask the question, this Infosys people, Narayana Murthy and everybody, we all think they're the gods. Yes, they are the gods. They created something else. But why did they sell it to abroad? Foreign, Infosys is owned by foreign people now. Why couldn't they develop something, this kind of Google or something like? Why they failed to develop? Why India has not been able to develop a single global brand of any sort? Somebody can be the richest Asian in the country. Everybody says so and so is the richest, Mukesh Ambani is the richest. But what has he created for India, which every Indian can use? So there is no Zuckerberg mentality in this country. So I think Modi has given the right thing, but should ensure that it is implemented on the ground. Because he moves from one slogan to another, to another, to another. Swachh Bharat, made in India, ye sab hota hai. Uske baad he forgets, because he realizes ki ye implement nahi hota.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir, for telling us that Local for Vocal is futuristic. We will definitely become self-reliant. So moving on to the next question, we have Khushi Upadhyay from Grade 12.
Good afternoon, sir. I, Khushi of Grade 12, would like to ask you a question. The education industry has been one of the quickest to adjust and the situation and function smoothly. When most of the things came to stand still, what do you see as the way forward? There is a limitation in terms of things that can be done online. For example, lab experiments.
Lab experiment is something which can not be done online, but it can be, instruction can be given online, because telemedicine is happening now. Doctors are giving you medicine online now. When the surgery is required, of course, that is the biggest problem. But the online practical, because I'm not a science student, but I was a teacher of the university for 10 years. So I've gone to various labs. I've seen the lab as well. What you're saying, online is a part of life now. You have to recognize this fact first, that going forward, more and more online education facilities be available. For example, there are online apps now for IAS officers. You have got Byju's, you have got An Academy, you have got Rao Circle. Everybody is giving you online instructions also. There were earlier also, there were School of Correspondence courses. Every early university used to have some correspondence course where you, they will send you the lecture printed and you will read and appear for the exam. Education industry, when you call it an industry, because I thought it was yet to become an industry. But most of the professionals, you have got 400 universities, which are private universities, which are running on the basis of privatization. Education in India cannot be a commerce. It has to be some kind of a cost plus basis. They are not charities. Yes, nobody is going to spend the money from his or her pocket to run an educational institution. Birla and everybody used to run it, but they were getting profit from somewhere else and investing in the schools and colleges. But that thing has gone. Now education companies are running big education colleges, corporates are running hospitals. So therefore, they have the facilities. Online facilities will make you much more beneficial in the sense, if you have a combination of physical presence as well as online presence, you can go to the school less and less and go and study at home, because you can create the facilities at home. You are not going out, your exposure to the rest of the world during Corona times, I'm talking, because you never know how long it's going to stay. The online is something in which everybody must invest. And therefore, science students, they have some problem. Then there can be variation. Okay, so twice a week you can come to the lab and do the practical lab, which are required necessary. Otherwise, all the chemicals, everything you can have home. But that only thing is, some of the chemicals could be dangerous if they are not under control and watch, or somebody can be misused by the student at home and cause all sorts of accidents and incidents. So that has to be avoided. How you do it, that as a protocol has to be developed. But I would say that online teaching, online getting books, like book we are getting online, Kindle, you have got it. That is the one way of, it is not a fixed time. That gives you the advantage online. It is not fixed time. You can read any book, you can read any literature whenever you feel like reading. It is not 7 to 5 school, 7 to 1 school. So you can do something according to what you want to mood. It's a mood question. Because on your mood is ready to absorb something new, only then you can sit down and read it. Online is going to be a part of your system from now on. You should be ready for that. It will take little time for poor villagers to do it. Urban people are beneficial, because I only feel danger of online is that it will create a bigger wedge between the poor and the rich. Because poor students, villagers can't have the smartphone, they can't have the iPad, and they have to be looked after how they are going to do it. Modi ji should think about it, whether they create some kind of a virtual training and teaching center for them in the villages as well. So that's the only dangerous. Otherwise, that's a good thing, technology has to be used.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir. So now we have a question from the school's vice head girl, Yanvi Kalyani of grade 12.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Yanvi Kalyani of grade 12. Yeah. My question for you is, many state governments in India have watered down labor laws. Given the stress COVID-19 has created on labor force of India, is redefining labor laws that deal with basic labor rights a justified priority?
As a student of 12th class, you're asking about labor laws. I am very impressed. Because labor laws at the moment may not be part of your curriculum at the moment. What you are discussing. But it's a good question that you are quite some kind of a very enlightened citizen of India, which I call you, is concerned about everything else. What some states like Madhya Pradesh, UP, they tried to do, amend the laws, or labor laws, it worked. I believe in the principle of award and punish. You see, a person can't be getting promotion year after year because he's a permanent employee and not doing anything else. In my own organization, I see many people who don't file a story for months, but you can't sack them because they are permanent employees. There are other people who are temporary or under contract. They are much better and they are doing much better job. How do I differentiate? How do I award a merit versus non-merit? The labor laws, if are meant to exploit people, then they are bad. There should be a mechanism in which labor should be rewarded. It should not be punished. What is happening now, if labor laws are meant to, okay, I'm going to punish somebody I don't like. If productivity is good, there has to be mechanism there. But hire and fire mechanism, which is happening in the West, That in that form, we can't accept it because our 40%, 30% people still are below the poverty line. If they are working in labor system, they cannot be sacked. There has to be security system there. But make labor, it is the interest of the labor to have some kind of a system in which merit or productivity gives you encouragement to earn more. Current system, labor system, doesn't provide people to earn more than what they are getting. So this is a flaw in the labor law. That's whether I do anything like IAS officers also. I say the same thing to them. You are an Indian automatic service. You get promotion after every 15 years, whether you do work or don't do work, you are involved in something or not. India has not been able to achieve what it has because it's the IAS officer. They pass through the road every day and they still say, Nala is kaam nahi kar raha hai, sewage kaam nahi kar raha hai, sadak tooti padi hai. So, koi banwata nahi hai. Aankhe band karke chal dete hai ki red light lagi hai, chale jaate. If they start watching what is happening on the left and right while they are walking on the road, India would have been a better place to live. But there has to be punishment there. Because you are a district magistrate, under you have got crores of rupees, you still encroach him in happening on your thing. Ganda kuda pada hua hai, koi kaam pe nahi aa raha hai, but you are sitting in your air conditioned room and looking. I started my journey, I'm giving you a story of something very interesting. 40 years ago, when I went to a district magistrate in your Chamoli, unke district magistrate ke karke bahar, bada ghar hai, kyunki angrezon ne banaye hue, gaadi seedhi meri chali gayi. Koi stop karne wala nahi tha, kuch nahi tha. घंटी बजाई तो मजिस्ट्रेट साहब खुद बाहर आ गए. मैं प्रभु चावला इंडिया टुडे से हूँ, हाँ आप कितना दिन पढ़ते हैं, चाय वाय पिलाई, कोई एसी वेसी नहीं था कुछ. 2-3 years ago आई वेंट अगेन टू द सेम मजिस्ट्रेट हाउस. इट वॉज बैरिकेडेड, 4 walls were constructed around the same house. 4 बंदूक वाले बाहर खड़े थे, घर के बाहर उनका एक कमरा एक और बना हुआ था जहाँ उनका सेक्रेटरी बैठा हुआ था. उन्होंने फोन लिया, फिर मैं अंदर गया, उनके कमरे के चारों क्या पर्दे पट लगे हुए थे, क्या एयर कंडीशन लगे हुए. इज दैट इंडिया वांटेड? बिकॉज यू स्पेंड मोर मनी ऑन योर हाउस एंड योर सारा फैमिलिया देन यू स्पेंड आउट. उनके घर के बाद पहले कुछ नहीं था, वहां गंदी सड़कें थी, सब कुछ. तो आई एम कमिंग गिविंग यू एग्जांपल बिकॉज लेबर लॉज हैव बीन अमेंडेड दिस सिचुएशन बिकॉज दे अंडर. आई एम नॉट सेइंग दैट लेबर लॉज हैव बीन अमेंडेड दिस गवर्नमेंट बिकॉज दे हैव बिकम सडनली कि हमने करना है. दे वर अंडर प्रेशर फ्रॉम द इंडस्ट्री कि हम कोरोना हो गया, हम तो इंडस्ट्री तब लाएंगे आपके स्टेट में अगर आप लेबर लॉ चेंज करो. दैट्स रॉन्ग, एब्सोल्युटली रॉन्ग. व्हाई दे डू इट बिफोर कोरोना? अभी क्यों किया उन्होंने? तो द मोटिवेशन इज टू पनिश द लेबर, दैट इज नॉट एक्सेप्टेबल. इट शुड बी यूनिफॉर्म लेबर लॉज. दोज हु डू गुड वर्क दे शुड गेट रिवॉर्डेड, दोज हु बैड वर्क दे हैव नो प्लेस इन द वर्क प्लेस. यू विल एग्री ऑन दैट. इफ यू हैव टू बी प्रोडक्टिव, यू हैव टू क्रिएट वेल्थ, you should be afraid of being punished for not doing your work. Kab inki teacher nahi padhayenge class mein aakar ke. Hamari Delhi University ke andar main batata hu, main I was a leader also. Maine jab main leader ban gaya tab I was a lecturer of economics and teaching. Leader banne ke baad mere ko kya tha, koi action to ho nahi sakta mere upar. Main mahine mein 4 din jata tha, aakhri din zarur jata tha mahine ke, koi tankha leni hoti, baki jata hi nahi tha. Kuch nahi hua. ऐसे 25% टीचर्स हैं दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी के अंदर अभी भी हैं जो क्लासेस में नहीं जाते हैं, उनको तनख्वाह मिलती है. मैंने बिकेम ए रीडर ऑफ इंडियन एक्सप्रेस. आई न्यू दैट आई वाज डूइंग व्हाट आई वाज डूइंग, सो आई स्टार्टेड डूइंग द स्टोरी. 91 व्हेन आई वाज द रीडर ऑफ इंडियन एक्सप्रेस, मैंने हर कॉलेज में महिलाओं कॉलेज के अंदर के जाकर, आई थॉट विमेन आर मच मोर रिस्पॉन्सिबल. यस दे आर, बट आई डिड स्टडी ऑफ 7 women कॉलेज इन इंडिया. उनके यहाँ जब टाइम टेबल लगता है दीवार के ऊपर, दीवार के ऊपर मैंने नोट किया कि किस टीचर की क्लास में कौन सी क्लास में है. तो आई सेंड माय कैमरामैन एंड रिपोर्टेड टू दैट क्लास, यू फाइंड 20% विमेन टीचर्स आर मिसिंग, दे नेवर केम टू द क्लास. फिर उनके नाम छापने शुरू किए, दैट इज द इंटरेस्टिंग पार्ट. यस, नुबे छपा गार्गी कॉलेज में, सो एंड सो नहीं आए, छुट्टी पर भी नहीं थी. तीसरे दिन मेरे यहाँ 20 टीचर विमेन बैठ गई आके कॉलेज में दफ्तर के बाहर कि हमारा डाइवोर्स करा दोगे आप क्या, क्यों हमारे हस्बैंड पूछते हैं कहाँ गए थे तुम क्लास में. तो दीज आर द थिंग विच आर हैपनिंग. सो वन हैज टू टेक सम एक्शन बिकॉज सोसाइटी में देर आर ऑलवेज लैगर्ड एंड देर आर ऑलवेज फॉरवर्ड, दे डू इट, बट यू हैव टू हैव मेरिट बेस्ड सिस्टम इन द कंट्री. थैंक यू.
थैंक यू सर.
थैंक यू सर. वी नाउ हैव सिद्धि परिहार ऑफ ग्रेड 12.
हाउ मेनी मोर क्वेश्चन यू वांट टू टेक? How many more questions? Another 15 minutes?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah.
So my name is Siddhi Parihar, and my question for you is, do you think the pandemic has increased the work pressure of parents with both office and school running online from home? I'm watching my parents get along with both of them, but it's really difficult to convince a small child to attend online classes. So what's your point of view?
Your voice has missed. Say it again slowly.
Okay. So do you think pandemic has increased the work pressure of parents with both office and school running online from home? I'm watching my parents get along with both of them, but it's really difficult to convince a small child to attend online classes.
Absolutely right. You're absolutely right. I can see at my home also my daughter-in-law running around from one room with an iPad in one hand and another iPad in second hand. Yes, it has increased. But only a good thing is they have also started learning on the when they're sitting next to them, their children, they're also learning something which they had not learned earlier. For example, my daughter-in-law has learned Spanish now because my granddaughter is learning Spanish. She has learned Spanish also. Because it depends. It has increased the work because fortunately now, because parents, if they are, both the parents are working, then it would be a problem. Now most of the people are sitting at home. So parents also need some kind of a engagement, busy, and they also know their children are how good are in responding to the classes and looking at the positive side of it. There can be negative sides as well. Negative sides, as you rightly pointed out, coping with them is very difficult. It depends how much parents are involved in other things. If the parents are working, it's still going on, it is very difficult for them to sit at home, attend to the classes. But that has to be adjusted. These are temporary situations where you may not have. But as I said in the beginning, you will have online classes part of your system forever now. Because schools will come less and less contact. And even parents don't want to send their children to the school. But I would say the pandemic has brought the children and the parents closer. Bonding yada hua hai abhi. Pata lag raha hai un logon ko ki unki weaknesses kya hai ya unki strengths kya hai. So because as a grandfather, I was not interacting with them. They were not staying with me. Now they are staying with me. Earlier they were definitely staying. So as a grandfather, I have watched them and I got involved in them also. Something which they are doing, which I find that, okay, I should also learn these things. But pressure is definitely there. But as they say, there's nothing like free lunch. You have to invest in, and you're not investing in terms of money, but you're investing in terms of time. It is beneficial. Look at the positive side. A class, your child is also busy. Your parents are also busy. Both of them getting more important. My 3-year granddaughter, I got second son, 3-year granddaughter. She's also in online classes. She already sits in front of the screen. Whatever she finds interesting, she runs away, but she comes back. But I find at the 1 hour, she has come back with something she has learned. So I think you look at the positive side of everything, you will forget the negative things that you learn. Take it as a learning process that something new has happened and we have to cope with it.
Thank you so much.
That's a positive word that the parents and children are coming closer. We have the next question from Japneet Kaur of Grade 12.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yeah.
I'm Japneet Kaur from Grade 12. So recently, many news articles and interviews have come up that say that the post-pandemic world will experience the dissolving of many jobs as well as the emergence of new career opportunities. So what are your opinions regarding the situation?
No, you see, since I'm a media person and the media is the worst affected in pandemic, I told you earlier, because we depend on advertising and media is the first, you can, there's a sounding board where you can find out what is happening in the country. You must have seen most of the newspaper may have stopped coming to your house or number of pages must have come down. You must have noticed that. So dissolving a job, if you're saying the 30% reduction in staff has happened across the media, people, some television channels are closing down. Biggest channels have also stopped recruiting people. Salaries are down by 30-45%. But I would say certain media houses were very high cost, top heavy. Most of the people have paid much higher salary. You can't imagine what they were being paid. So they were overpaid. It is leveling has come down. They have come down to the level which sounds little. Even their hires, it is reasonable now. But media was very expensive proposition, particularly TV channel, where editors were getting into crores per year. So that level has come down and advertising has come down by almost 80%, 90%. Government, every government doesn't have, look at the chain reaction. Government gets taxes. They have stopped getting the taxes. If they stop getting the taxes, they won't advertise. They won't pay salary. So it is a chain which is happening. Motorcycle will not sell, he will not advertise. So we are the first point where we suffered because of that. But new opportunities are coming in terms of, for example, we started the online, we have started promotion. Online selling business is cheaper also, becoming another opportunity because it is low cost also. Having a Zoom meeting without any cost, which I paid the license fee, which is the only cost I got, or my salary, which I is not charging anyway, because there is no money to pay for me. But otherwise I'm saying, it new opportunities are being created. People will learn to earn more by spending less. That's the good thing about pandemic, is that you will be able, most of the executives of top companies have been asked to stay, work from home, because technology is there. So offices are being closed because of the high cost of offices over there. Their offices rents have come down. They got special money, spare money to spend on something else. So people are working from home. Their travel cost has gone down. Petrol cost has gone down. So therefore, another 6 months, a lot of money would be saved in the system because there's no electricity consumed in the offices. There are no other excess capital happening. So that losses will come down. I think things from now, people start getting more jobs. New jobs will come. Technology related, pharma related, lifestyle related. These things will come out once you start roads, infrastructure start building, because government has to do something. I think future is not that bad. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So we now have a question from Pradhana Abrol of Grade 10.
Good afternoon, sir. I'm Pradhana Abrol from Grade 10. So, sir, a couple of days before, I was just, talking to my friends over a call. And most of my friends are actually sports lovers. They are a lot into sports. And to be precise, they are all swimmers. So, you know, they all were just tripping and, you know, complaining over the phone and telling me that, you know, our practices have stopped. We're just sitting at home because of this crisis. We're getting unfit. We really miss our practices. Some of them even told me that, you know, they feel that they've forgotten how to play their sport. So while they were just telling me all these complaints, a question struck me, which I would like to ask you today. So, sir, my question for you is, how do you think competitions in sports like swimming would be organized in times of COVID-19, as for any competition, 2 to 3 people have to step into the same pool?
You're absolutely right. These are valid questions. If you go back and search my Facebook, you'll find an interview with Kiran Riju, who's the sports minister. I asked him the same question you're asking me. Question is, we are not the only country which is affected by the, in terms of sports, we are out of 200 countries, we are very low. 8, 9 medals, no gold medal in any game in the Olympics. So as far as the sports is concerned, we are much more behind because sports culture is yet to develop in India. Because people are not spending on sports as much as they should have. Big industries are not spending. But COVID is something where social distancing is a must for some time. Now they are allowing matches without the spectator, without the viewers, whatever is going to happen. So people will be playing IPL in some ground where nobody will be allowed. Even the Rath Yatra, Jagannath Ji Yatra happened in Odisha, which is all online. People are watching from home. So these are the compulsions of a situation. Competition-wise, of course, you can't compete without practicing. But the question, you are not the only one. There are others all over the world, people are facing the same situation. So their competition level is also going down as much as yours. So everybody is going down instead of going up in terms of practice. So you should be thinking that way. Okay, I'm not being allowed to do practice, so is my competition. So therefore, in America, they have opened up something. It's going to open up there. Swimming pools, for example, in certain houses and clubs where 1 or 2 people can go. Even the hotels are closed, gyms are closed, they are going to open also. Question is whether you want to live now for a bigger competition, a healthier competition 3 months from now, or you want to sink in the pool now without competing with anyone. That's the choice you have to make. Choice is that it's a compulsion and you are not the only one. Your competitor is also suffering from the same problem which you are. And when they open up, you will also open up. And you will then find your best competitor to themselves. They depend on them. So you do it's a leveler. Pandemic has leveled everybody. Nobody's up and down.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome. Thank you, sir. So we have the last question of the day by our school's head girl, Anushka Nahata from Grade 12.
Yeah.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
I'm Anushka Nahata from Grade 12.
As the pandemic going on, people think that sitting at home is a waste of time. Therefore, we are being loaded with a lot of work. During this time, people are trying to become master chef or trying to master one activity or the other to show their progress on social media. So, do you think that in the race of being productive during the pandemic is leading to further stress?
It depends. Again, I say, how you look at it. Question is, I look at it very positively. Because what is the option for me? Can you go out? No. Can you call your friends at home? No. So if you can't do anything else, how do you kill your 24 hours at home? So you have to do something which you want to stress-wise. It's no compulsion on you. You can lay on the bed and say, okay, mani karungi kuch bhi mata bethi. Parents kehte rahe kuch bhi. That is your choice. But people now started learning even cleaning their whole houses, pocha utha karke, jhadu utha ke log kaam bhi karte. So this is something which you have to look because you are being compelled to stay at home, not of, because of your choice. It is a natural compulsion on you. Out of that compulsion, you create an opportunity. Why you don't think that is a compulsion which leads to creating an opportunity? In that opportunity, which you to win, you are going for 6 hours in a school. Those 6 hours are available to you extra at home. During those 6 hours, you have got the classes, online classes. आप यहाँ लगती हैं कितनी लगती होंगी? बाकी आप सब घर में हैं, तो क्या कर सकते हैं? क्या आपको मास्टर शेफ बनने में आजकल है कि मैं लड़के आज अब खाना ज्यादा बनाते हैं लड़कियां कम बनाती हैं क्योंकि उनको शौक है खाना बनाने का. आप लोगों को पता है खाना कैसे बनाते हैं. गर्ल्स आर नोन, उनको तो हर चीज आती है, इसलिए लड़कों को कंपटीशन करना पड़ता है. मास्टर शेफ आर गेटिंग सैलरीज इनटू करोड़ दीज. यू मे लुक एट इट इन अ डिफरेंट वे. एवरी प्रोफेशन इज डिफरेंटली देयर. देयरफॉर एक्वायरिंग एन एक्स्ट्रा स्किल, व्हाई यू लुक एट इट एज अ स्ट्रेस, आई जस्ट कांट अंडरस्टैंड. इट डिपेंड्स ऑन योर ओन चॉइस बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली you have to decide what you want to do when you can't go out. If you are being forced to stay home because your opportunity was there, you can go out. You can't. Huh? You can't go without a mask. You can't go without gloves. You can't touch anybody. You can't sit next to anybody. You can't talk to your friends. So when it is forced, it is not that you have, it has been forced by nature. It is not a human compulsion or restriction on you. When the restrictions are not man-made, how do you cope with it? ये तो आपको सोचना है ना कि आपको इसको stress में बदलना है या opportunity बदलना है कि ये ऐसा ही time है. इसके अंदर जो कई बार कहते हैं आखिरी question है, मैं उर्दू का शहर होता था ना, कि कहा था कि खुद ही को कर बुलंद उतना हर एक शह से पहले खुदा बंदे से खुद पूछे बता तेरी रजा क्या है. कोविड में आप अपने आप को इतना बड़ा बना दीजिए किसी चीज में कि आपके स्कूल के एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर जो बैठे हैं यहाँ पर प्रिंसिपल, वो आपसे पूछे ओके मिस नाटा व्हाट डू यू वांट नाउ, यू आर द ब्रिलियंट स्टूडेंट ऑफ माय क्लास, यू हैव लर्न सो मेनी थिंग्स विच नो अदर पर्सन, देयर शुड बी कंपटीशन अमंग्स देम. व्हेन वी गो बैक टू स्कूल वी विल टेल द प्रिंसिपल ओके प्रिंसिपल सर इन दिस जो हमारा क्लब है हमारा स्कूल है इसके हमने इतने सारे नई चीजें क्रिएट किए हैं कि वी कैन क्रिएट a competition globally in this field. That should be the spirit behind you student. Use the time to become the best student, best Indian citizen first and global citizen later. That's my advice.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
With that, we come to an end of all the questions from the side of the students. So we did have a lot of questions, but so due to the time constraint, we will have to stop taking them. But sir, seeing all my friends asking you so many questions, even I felt tempted to ask you one last question.
Please go ahead.
So all of us asked you about our changing priorities, but I would want to know that are your priorities too being redefined in the times of COVID? If yes, how?
Sir, say it again.
All of us asked you about changing priorities, but yeah. I would want to know that are your priorities too being redefined in the times of COVID? If yes, how?
Of course, you have to change your priorities. Yes, of any use. How is the question? You have to improve your skills. You have to make yourself a better human being. You have to make yourself a better person who's most acceptable, more credible. You come back with a more productive in terms of mind, in terms of thinking. You have to be most innovative. You should be a wow person. So that is the priority. because you have got time at your disposal. You have no restriction. You have got the opportunities with all the time, with all the equipment, with all the attention. You should become the best person, which you were not earlier. You may be better. Priorities, I can't depend on your background because depends on your nature, your liking, disliking, which I am not access to. My feeling is that use your priority, your mind, physical priority, your mental priority. What you like, you must do without fear, without favor. You will be the best person.
So you definitely are the wow person. Thank you so much, sir. Now, I would like to call upon the school's head girl, Anushka Nahata, to give the vote of thanks.
Good afternoon, everyone. As all good things come to an end, so does this webinar. On behalf of Ecole Global International Girls School, I take this opportunity to propose the vote of thanks to those who have directly and indirectly contributed to this webinar. At the outset, I thank our guest, Prabhu Chawla, sir. We are really enlightened with your knowledge and presence. I would like to thank our principal, Manija Subramaniam, for her enthusiastic support. A special thanks to the organizing team, teaching and non-teaching faculty for their unflinching support and coordination. A heartfelt thanks to my fellow class schoolmates for their active participation. With this, we move to the end of today's webinar. Yes, this is only the first session of VoiceIt, but we will be back soon with the next VoiceIt conversation. Until then, stay safe, stay happy. Thank you for being with us today. Have a great day ahead.
Thank you. Wish you all the best.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.